I'm Jeff Eisenband, and I'm here to talk about Maria Sharapova. On Monday night, Sharapova returned to Grand Slam tennis as a wild card at the U.S. Open, where she knocked off Simona Halep in three sets. Ironically, the number two seed Halep has been very vocal against Sharapova attaining wild cards. After Sharapova won, she dropped to the ground with emotion. Sharapova called the win so much more than a normal match. Her crystal dress glistened in the Queen's Night, and the New York crowd cheered like it was 2015. But it's not 2015, it's 2017, and Maria Sharapova does not deserve the sympathy that she seeks. Don't get me wrong, I'm fine with her playing tennis again. She's one of the best in the world, and she served her time. But also, don't get me wrong, she cheated. She took a banned substance, was found guilty, and paid a price. This is not a player coming back from an uncontrollable struggle, such as an injury or a personal loss. This is a player who could have gained a competitive advantage, but was caught. Her suspension was her fault, whether intentional or not. If you drive through a stop sign in front of the police station and you don't mean to do it, you still get a ticket. Not that that ever happened to me. And yeah, I'll say it. Can you imagine if this was Serena Williams coming back from a 15-month PED suspension? She already gets booed around the world, including the US sometimes, just because of the way she plays. People would hammer her with taunts. Just ask Justin Gatlin. If you're a Sharapova fan and root for her because of the way she plays, go right ahead. But if you feel a sense of pity, come on now. The system worked, and now it's time to move on. For the postgame, this is Jeff Eisenband. Enjoy the US Open.